And students across California weren't taking the passage of Prop 209 quietly. We'll tell you who else is launching a challenge to that measure.
Happy trails to you.
And we will tell you why it is happy trails once more for Roy Rogers' sidearms. We'll have those stories and a lot more coming up next in just a moment on the 10 o'clock report.
Keep smiling.
Nobody does it like you, the way that you do.
Ordinary hand vacs can't always clean those hard-to-reach places. So now Hoover introduces the Twistin' Vac, the only hand vac with a nozzle that twists, and a powerful revolving brush. So now even hard-to-reach places are easy to reach, easy to clean. It's a whole new twist on cleaning.
Hoover, nobody does it like you.
The Taurus is the best-selling car in America, and Ford's in a battle to make sure it stays there, with one of the best deals ever on a new 96. Now you can buy a Taurus with a low 1.9 APR. That's right, 1.9. Not for 2 or 3 years, but for 4 full years. Or $2,000 cash back. And that's before your dealer throws in his best deal. Get the best-selling Taurus with a 1.9 or $2,000 cash back and save some serious cash.
Howdy.
I used to love your Philly cheesesteak.
The tender strips of steak, grilled onions and peppers, smothered in melting cheese.
Fond memories.
I cried when you stopped making them.
I just remembered. The Philly cheesesteaks are back.
No!
Yes, but only for a limited time.
Hey, we better hurry. You want a police escort?
Sure.
Okay. Let's go.
Experience the freedom of ticketless travel. Ticketless travel on Southwest Airlines, the easiest way to fly.
6.9% introductory APR. No annual fee the first year. And a way to turn everyday purchases into free flights. The new Southwest Airlines Rapid Rewards Visa Card. Because even little things can add up.
Alcohol abuse is a grave mistake.
You're watching the home of Southern California's most honored local news, KCAL 9, Los Angeles. Now, it's 10 o'clock, time for all today's late-breaking news and a look ahead at tomorrow. KCAL 9 News 10 o'clock report.
We have 3 cars in direct pursuit of him, and it looks like 5 other police cars in jail.
It was a case of speed and greed. Speed so great it put other drivers in harm's way. And then a greed so strong it stopped the suspect right in his tracks and landed him in jail. It was a wild chase at speeds over 100 miles an hour, even though the suspect had a blown right front tire.
It began with a bank robbery and ended with the suspect running from the broken down car and money flying everywhere. Catherine Blake has the story.
It was a really dangerous pursuit. We had over 100 miles an hour for long periods of time.
It's amazing Juan Lamon doesn't hit anyone during this dramatic game of cat and mouse. The 42-year-old races within inches of other vehicles during the hour-long pursuit. It all begins after LeMond allegedly robs this California Federal Bank in Lake Forest just after 10 this morning.
As he was leaving the area, the bank employees gave a description to the deputies that were responding, and the deputies saw this individual trying to get on the Interstate 5 freeway from El Toro Road. Tried to stop the car, and the guy fled.
I'm showing 101 miles per hour, and I'm just barely catching up to him.
Orange County and L.A. law enforcement officers quickly track LeMond from the ground and the air. His erratic path covers more than 60 miles on and off the freeway in Orange County and Long Beach. He often tops speeds of 110 miles per hour, blasting across medians, through intersections, and into oncoming traffic. At one point, he comes dangerously close to pedestrians. It all comes to a bizarre end on the northbound 5 freeway near Brookhurst in Anaheim.
His right front tire fell off the car. He exited his vehicle, jumped the freeway, made it to a second fence, which is reported by Constantino Wire, and that was the end of him. He stopped there.
He was like right here, right over here, as the money was strewn all over the ground.
LeMond manages to jump over the freeway median and cross the southbound lanes before he's caught. Workers from a nearby business watch in disbelief as LeMond scrambles to collect cash on the ground.
I couldn't believe it. He must be greedy. I mean, bad greedy. Because he just dropped on the ground, started digging in the dirt trying to get the money. I couldn't believe it. He was trying to get over this fence right here, trying to get in the bushes.
The FBI says LeMond is wanted for two other recent bank holdups in Orange County. Investigators say his actions today will result in charges of bank robbery and felony evading arrest. In Anaheim, Catherine Blake, KCAL 9 News.
Fortunately, this high-speed chase ended without injury, even though one sheriff's car did clip another vehicle on the freeway. David.
Well, Pat, he brought basketball glory back to Westwood, and now he's getting run out of town. UCLA fired head basketball coach Jim Herrick today. Our Gary Cruz is in the newsroom right now to explain exactly why. Gary.
But David, depending on who you talk to, there are several explanations why Jim Herrick was fired. The opinion that matters the most, though, is that of the man who runs UCLA and canned Herrick. Nine Sports' John Ireland has more.
If you believe the UCLA administration, Jim Herrick was officially fired today for only one reason. He filed a false expense report from a recruiting dinner and then lied about it. According to the man who fired him, he did nothing else wrong.
Coach Herrick conducted himself in a manner that was inconsistent not only with NCAA rules and regulations, but with his position as a role model to student athletes for ethical behavior. Is so important.
If you believe Jim Herrick, who is planning legal action, he did make a mistake on an expense report, but he was never told he might be fired. Actually, he says he was told that the situation had been resolved.
There's never been one word about Jim Herrick of demeaning character. And all of a sudden, boom. If I made a mistake, then I did make a mistake. But to be fired? No.
And so begins one of the strangest firings in Los Angeles sports history. It was just 19 months ago that Herrick led UCLA to their first national title in 20 years. When it comes to ethics, he's been accused of wrongdoing, but his career record is spotless. He is 1 year into a five-year contract that pays him hundreds of thousands of dollars, but today he was fired without severance pay, out of the blue, for one mistake. The school insists it wasn't the mistake, it was the lying afterwards.
I hate to overdo it, but I think Watergate is the analogy. The break-in to the Democratic National Committee headquarters was not all that big an act, but what followed it brought down the President of the United States.
In Westwood, I'm John Ireland, KCAL 9 Sports.
So what's next? Well, 32-year-old Steve Lavin has been named interim head coach for the upcoming season. The good news for Steve is the fact that he has the entire roster back from last year's 23-8 NCAA tournament team. The bad news for Steve is the uncertainty in the upcoming recruiting wars with the likes of Duke, Georgetown, Indiana, and other high-profile teams with high-profile coaches. David, a lot of work, a lot of answers, and a lot of more questions out at UCLA tonight.
There really are a lot more questions. Yeah, was Jim Herrick not very popular with the administration for a period of months up until this time, or has that not been true?
That's safe to say. Yes, he was not popular with some people within the administration, and I think that more of these situations and more things involving his, I guess, discord with some of the folks within the administration will come out as the days unravel.
And was that just a matter of style, or was it over specifics, or why was it that they didn't like him?
Well, they just clashed, and for whatever reason, David, but I'll tell you what, to be fired over an expense report violation seems incredibly trivial, although it certainly wasn't to Chancellor Young and the athletic department at UCLA.
Yeah, no pay, no nothing. Yeah. Okay.
I mean, think about it. All the other schools that have maintained coaches that have been put on death sentences for probation, things of that nature. You know, you think about what happened there, and it something doesn't work right.
No, you're right. Okay, Gary. Thanks.
All right. Pat.
From 13 to 187, California has a history of passing groundbreaking initiatives. This year was no different, with two controversial propositions winning wide support. Voters passed Prop 215, legalizing the use of marijuana as a medical treatment. despite strong opposition from law enforcement. Also passing Prop 209, the so-called California Civil Rights Initiative, which would eliminate affirmative action programs in state education, hiring, and contracting. The votes were still being counted when proponents of Prop 209 declared legal war on the initiative. For more on what lies ahead, we go to Frank Buckley, who's live at Cal State Los Angeles. Frank.
Pat, this is one place where the effects of Proposition 209 might be felt, although so far state officials aren't exactly sure how that would happen. One thing we do know, from California state universities to California state agencies, affirmative action programs will be eliminated if Proposition 209 is implemented. Students angry with the passage of Proposition 209 protested at UC San Diego.
No university without diversity!
While about 100 students at UC Santa Cruz blocked the entrance to the Student Services Building. But the protests may have fallen on deaf ears. Today, the provost for the UC campus system ordered chancellors at the 9 University of California schools to no longer consider race or sex in their decisions on admission. It was perhaps the first of a wave of similar orders to come, because Proposition 209 bans preferences and affirmative action in state hiring, contracting, and education. Governor Pete Wilson said this morning that the measure would help to correct what he considered an injustice.
It ensures that state government and that other public agencies in this state will no longer be guilty of discriminating against any Californian by discriminating in favor of some.
But opponents of the measure were ready, filing a federal lawsuit to block the implementation of Proposition 209.
We have asked the court for a temporary restraining order preventing the proposition from going into effect.
Governor Wilson wasted no time in making sure that 209 was on track for implementation, issuing an executive order and a deadline to state agencies to identify those programs that permit preferences.
I'm scared for women businesses.
Lisa Campbell is a woman contractor who fears the effects of 209. She says today her male counterparts were already giving her a hard time.
There has been ribbing about, we don't have to play with you anymore. Ribbing, teasing, and let's see if it's teasing, let's see if it's reality.
Campbell says affirmative action for female contractors simply meant that they were notified of contracts so they too could bid for the work. Now she fears those days are over.
With affirmative action, they had to notify it in the paper. They had to notify somewhere that there is work coming down the pike, where now they're saying, we don't have to do that. So therefore, it narrows the playing field down to a very select few.
And of course, supporters of Proposition 209 see it quite differently. They say, in fact, that what the proposition does is that it levels the playing field for everyone. They have filed a lawsuit of their own in state court seeking enforcement of Proposition 209. So it appears at this point that for now, Proposition 209 will be battled once again in the courts. I'm Frank Buckley reporting live from Cal State LA. Pat, back to you.
Any idea how long this could go on? For example, I know 187 still hasn't been decided, has it?
Yeah, Pat, 187 has been dragging through the courts, but this time the people feel that it's going to be settled within a few months. They don't expect that this one will be dragged through the courts for years. And in fact, this time supporters of Proposition 209 believe that maybe the courts will work in their favor, forcing enforcement of this ballot initiative.
All right. Thank you for that, Frank.
Well, like Prop 209, Proposition 215 is likely to go from the ballot box right to the courthouse. Prop 215 would legalize the medical use of marijuana, but many say that it's already created a legal mess. Amy Huggins has that story.
Those who use marijuana for medical reasons cheered at the Cannabis Buyers Club as the vote totals came in last night during a potluck supper.
Because of the marijuana, I've been able to eat a good diet and take the necessary vitamins. I've had a dramatic change in my health status, too, in the last 3 months.
Downstairs, a volunteer was cited for possessing marijuana.
They asked if I had any marijuana on me. And I said, yes, I do.
Where is it now?
They have it.
It appeared to be a staged and strangely timed event, complete with a public relations person.
I can't really reveal a whole lot of information. We are conducting an investigation. Beyond that, we cannot comment, but we are currently enforcing current laws in California.
President Clinton, Bob Dole, and law enforcement officials opposed 215. It is a vaguely worded measure that is, in the words of one opponent, confusing and without precedent.
We're going to have what I would call legal or law enforcement chaos, maybe even anarchy, in the sense that the federal law will continue to be there. The state laws now change. Some people may have a false sense that they can do it and it's still going to be illegal.
That kind of posturing has been rejected. The significance of this is that common sense has prevailed, that when a person needs a necessary medicine to alleviate their pain, to get them through chemotherapy, that's what the voters want to see happen.
Backers say the measure does not legalize marijuana.
Patients can still be arrested today, tomorrow, next year, if an arresting officer feels that they are abusing the privileges of 215.
Supporters say language will be clarified and enabling legislation introduced soon. While the governor promises that users will be prosecuted, proponents bet that federal authorities will not be arresting people here.
In order for the DEA to come into California and arrest someone on possession, they have to bring that case to a jury in federal court. And it's very difficult to imagine a jury in a state that just passed Prop 215 by a 56-44 margin giving them a conviction in a case involving a patient using marijuana.
The battle over 215 may be just beginning. Amy Huggins, KCAL 9 News.
The U.S. drug czar says that he plans to meet with Attorney General Janet Reno to discuss 215 and how it will affect federal drug enforcement efforts.
Well, not all the races are as decisive. Several are still too close to call. Among them, the race for district attorney. D.A. Gil Garcetti holds a slim lead over challenger John Lynch by only 6,800 votes. Now, the winner won't be known until tens of thousands of absentee ballots are counted next week. In the 43rd Congressional District, Democrat Scott Wildman leads John Geranios by about 500 votes. In the 54th District, Republican Stephen Kuykendall is in front of Jerry Shipsky by less than 1,000. And in the 56th, Democrat Sally Havas leads Republican Richard Lambros by less than 2,000.
Well, the counting of absentee ballots is in full gear, but it's still going to be a long and agonizing wait for candidates that are in tight races. Workers at the Registrar Recorder's Office in Norwalk are working double shifts to get the job done. Before the ballots can be counted, the signatures have to be checked, and that takes some time.
120,000 or so came in, as you know, the last couple weeks during our registration deadline. We're still scanning some of those. So if those people had applied for an absentee, we have to go to find their signature on the Recordax. That's our microfilm system.
So it won't be until next week before we get a clearer picture of the winners in several of those tight races. Well, he was arrested 3 times within 1 month.
Now actor Robert Downey Jr. finds out if he'll have to spend time in jail for drug charges.
And I'm Angie Crouch. A growing number of Hollywood stars are refusing to do interviews with Entertainment Tonight. Today, the studio backed down. Find out what's happening when we come back.
And he's only a teenager, but this new Laker's making all the right moves. We'll have the story later on the 10 o'clock report.
Over the years, the Los Angeles Lakers have been the stuff that legends were made of. Wilt, Jerry, Kareem, Magic, you know, legends. But this Laker team wants to create a legend of its own with new guys and a new winning tradition. LA is where the Lakers play, and the Lakers play on KCAL 9, where you can watch new Laker legends begin.
The Lakers face the Raptors Friday at 5 on KCAL 9, LA's pro sports leader.
There's a global company that can help you reach overseas markets as if they were right next door. A company that can speed packages across the Atlantic or the Pacific for less than you'd probably pay to send them across town. The U.S. Postal Service offers global priority mail around the country and around the world. No one delivers like the U.S. Postal Service.
The 97 Accord. Still fun after all these years.
Take one for a ride at your Honda dealer.
Nearly 70% of Hawaii's native bird species have disappeared forever. But for the endangered Hawaiian stilt, hope comes in an unlikely sanctuary in the heart of a refinery, protected and nurtured by the people who work there. Do people help nature reach a new dawn? People do.
Much of the O.J. Simpson civil trial has been a repeat of the criminal trial, but today, first-run evidence, a photographer testifying about a picture of Simpson wearing what may be Bruno Mali's shoes, like the ones that left bloody prints at the murder scene. Analysts say that it may be significant since Simpson denies ever owning such shoes.
Suppose he is denied ever wearing shoes like that. If the jury finds that he's not telling the truth on that point, it'll really hurt him in two regards. So, you know, they'll distrust other things he may say, and this will also put him near the scene or at the scene of the crime.
Also today, a glove expert testified that a series of pictures shows Simpson wearing the same brand and style of gloves that were used in the murders. The defense countered by playing the tape from the criminal trial showing Simpson struggling to try on the bloody gloves. Well, in a way, former Simpson criminal lawyer Robert Shapiro is still on the case. Shapiro has been hired by CBS News as a commentator on the civil trial. But some say the attorney's ostensible lack of impartiality raises ethical questions. Another CBS analyst, Lori Levinson, reportedly threatened to resign over Shapiro's hiring, although the network denies that.
Well, David, Robert Downey Jr. will stay out of jail and on probation if he can stay away from drugs. A judge today sentenced Downey to 3 years probation for possession of heroin and cocaine, carrying a concealed weapon, and driving under the influence. Downey smiled but did not speak as he left the courtroom. However, his lawyer apologized to Downey's fans for him.
He feels bad about what happened and feels that he's let some of his fans and his public down, and he intends to make that up to everybody.
Downey has been in a live-in drug rehab program for 3 months. Under the judge's orders, he will stay there for another 3 months. What began as a cry in the show business jungle quickly turned into a chorus of celebrity disapproval. Now, in the war over hard copy paparazzi, Paramount Studios may have met its Waterloo. Angie Crouch joins us live now from Westwood with snapshots of today's victory. Angie.
Pat, Hollywood stars are boycotting one of TV's top entertainment shows because they're angry over paparazzi video. And as you can imagine, this scandal is all the buzz here tonight at the Westwood premiere of the new movie, The English Patient. Wherever there are celebrities these days, you'll also find the paparazzi. Photographers eager to get that unique shot of one of America's favorite stars. But as of today, these shutterbugs will have one less place to sell their pictures. Paramount Television, which owns Entertainment Tonight and the show Hard Copy, announced it will no longer buy paparazzi footage that intrudes on celebrity privacy. That may include tapes like this memorable video of actors Alec Baldwin and wife Kim Basinger coming home from the hospital with their newborn baby. Baldwin was later acquitted of assault charges for hitting the photographer. ER actor George Clooney started all of this. Last week, he boycotted Entertainment Tonight after its sister show Hard Copy aired a story about him. Clooney was soon joined by other celebrities, including Madonna and Whoopi Goldberg, all refusing to do interviews with Entertainment Tonight. Today, Clooney issued a statement calling Paramount's decision a tremendous leap forward. But the star says, "What I cannot do is stop this movement just because we're close. If what they promise comes true, I will be the first to end this boycott." Paramount responded by saying, "We are delighted that George Clooney has responded favorably to our policy. We look forward to an ongoing positive relationship." At tonight's premiere, several stars told us they understand George Clooney's boycott, but they have no plans to join him.
I guess there's a line that can be crossed. It depends on the person, you know. So when people's privacy lines are crossed, they react.
It's really an amazing example of an actor wielding power, and I think it's great. I support it.
Will you wield that sort of power?
Maybe in 10 years from now. Maybe when I'm as famous and successful as George Clooney, I can snub the press, but not before.
And we're back live now in Westwood. You're looking at some of the paparazzi that's gathered here at this premiere. They say that if Hard Copy doesn't want their video, they're sure plenty of other TV shows will. As for George Clooney, he says he plans to tape the show Hard Copy every night to make sure that it keeps its promise. And if it does, he says he'll end his boycott. Reporting live in Westwood, I'm Angie Crouch. Pat, back to you.
Does he have a ratings box?
That's right.
Thank you, Angie.
Western movie legend Roy Rogers was known for his horse, Trigger, and for his trigger finger. Imagine Rogers upset then after discovering some of his triggers had been fingered. The good news is that all 12 of the valuable weapons stolen from the Roy Rogers Dale Evans Museum have now been recovered. The museum is operated by Rogers' daughter, Cheryl. After the guns disappeared, one of them turned up at a black powder shooting club in Ojai. Further investigation led to capture of a suspect in Victorville and return of the missing firearms. Now it is happy trails for them once again. Well, President Clinton celebrates the start of another 4 years on Pennsylvania Avenue.
But several of his cabinet members say they've had enough. We'll tell you who may be on the way out.
Affects my family, and I just feel it's really, really important.
And she wasn't going to let labor pain stop her from exercising her democratic right. The story next on the 10 o'clock report.
Police chased this man through two states, and now he holds his estranged wife hostage. See how he's brought to justice. Tell a friend. If it happens, when it happens, it's on Real TV.
Tomorrow night at 6:30 on KCAL 9.
Nobody knows me like me. My body's a temple. I should be the guru.
Lived in this body my whole life. That makes me the landlord.
Now there's an HMO that understands. With No Access Plus HMO from Blue Shield of California, you can see your primary care physician first, or go straight to a participating specialist in your medical group.
My body's a roadmap, and I am the guide.
Access, one of many new things behind the shield. Blue Shield.
Nobody knows me like me.
The new Dodge.
Where do you find something that is cool, refreshing, and makes you feel good all over? A few clues.
You can out-drive, out-hustle, out-tough, out-muscle, out-tow, out-run, out-work, and out-fun. Show them what you got.
At California's Truck Stop, you can get air conditioning at no extra charge when you buy a new Dodge Ram. Bet that sends a chill through the competition.
California's Truck Stop. The new Dodge.
I've been around this land of ours from sea to shining sea. And if it stands for anything, it's that every man is free. Free to roam from city to city, to ride the open range. Free to come and go at will, to grab hold of the reins. But if you want to see the country in its glory and its pride, you've got to have a trusty mount that's always ready to ride.
All across the nation, people are asking the same question. Where's Candace?
I don't know what happened to her. All I did was show her how I count my dimes. 1 minute, 2 minutes.
It Sprint's Dime a Minute thing, man. It's so totally popular, she's gone into hiding.
Now comes news that Sprint's made it even better.
Now you can get 10 cents a minute, 24 hours a day, to the number you call the most.
Well, that's great news, but will we ever see Candace again?
Don't hold your breath.
Call now for 10 cents a minute, 24 hours a day, to the number you call the most.
President Clinton returned to the nation's capital, where the first order of business is replacing outgoing cabinet members. Among the known departures, Defense Secretary William Perry, who is retiring. Secretary of State Warren Christopher, who's also retiring. Energy Secretary Hazel O'Leary is resigning under criticism of her extensive foreign trips. And Mickey Cantor plans to step down as trade representative, but may take another job within the administration. Word of these departures comes in the wake of impending exits by White House Chief of Staff Leon Panetta and senior White House aide George Stephanopoulos.
Despite cabinet changes, the president is savoring political victory. Tonight, a White House celebration for campaign supporters. Earlier today, heartfelt thanks to White House staffers and a brief history lesson from the vice president.
I said last night in presenting the president at the victory celebration,
Vice President Al Gore read the short list of other Democratic presidents elected to two terms.
An extraordinary list. Thomas Jefferson, James Madison, James Monroe, Andrew Jackson, Woodrow Wilson, Franklin Delano Roosevelt, and now William Jefferson Clinton.
The vice president then read the short list of other Democratic vice presidents elected to two terms.
Thomas Marshall. Daniel Tompkins. John Garner. And George Clinton.
This allowed the vice president to make a link between shadows of the past to shades of the future.
So from George Clinton to, from Clinton to Gore. It's great to be able to. No.
Staffers chatted 12 more years before Gore calmed them down and introduced his boss the next 4 years, President Clinton. Then it was the president's turn for a little fun.
I'll tell you one thing. You remember what John Nance Garner said about the vice presidency? Said it wasn't worth a warm, kettle of spit or something like that. That's before Al Gore got a hold of it.
Nobody the president then took a moment to reflect on the next 4 years, saying his administration has earned America's trust.
This race was won because of the record we made and because of the plans we have and because we have established in the minds of the American people that it's more than talk with us, that we work at it hard every day.
All but four cabinet members were at the celebration. Some wore welcome home T-shirts under business suits, including outgoing Secretary of State Warren Christopher.
Well, a pregnant Northern California woman was just about to give birth, but that did not stop her from casting her ballot. On election day, Krishna Hamilton had intended to vote. She always does. But this year, she found herself in a local hospital, contractions coming just 3 minutes apart. With just moments to spare, her husband skipped out to vote.
The clerk there said, you know, your wife can still vote. I can take her the ballot. And I said, come on, because she really wants to vote.
He went and voted and came back and said, they're bringing you a ballot. And I said, okay. You got to help me.
Krishna has her voting stub to prove that she voted and a new healthy baby boy. Daniel was born just as President Clinton delivered his acceptance speech. And if you need proof that your vote counts out there, take a look at some of the California races that are still too close to call.
Yes, one of the most hotly fought contests is in Orange County. Only a couple of hundred votes separate Bob Dornan and Loretta Sanchez. We'll tell you what could make the difference in this race ahead on the 10 o'clock report.
Roseanne interviews Iron Mike Tyson for Inside Edition.
Watch me.
The gloves are off as they go one-on-one, sharing intimate secrets and a whole lot of fun.
Look out for me and Mike on Inside Edition.
Tomorrow night at 7 on KCAL 9.
On the next American Journal, meet OJ's new friend, a beautiful woman who looks just like Nicole Brown Simpson. Plus, we're taking Vanna White and her son back to her hometown next AJ.
Tomorrow night at 7:30 on KCAL 9.
Gather around the grill. El Pollo Loco's got a big deal. Our 10-piece family special, $7.99. 10 juicy marinated flame-broiled pieces. A stack of warm tortillas. Freshly made salsa on the side. Goes really far. All for $7.99. You got something better on the stove? I don't think so. El Pollo Loco, it's a big deal.
Wake up, world. Hyundai's a whole new car company. You won't listen to me? Then read. Educate yourself.
Car and driver says the Elantra wagon's engine is gutsy. It's actually fun to drive.
And a 5-year limited powertrain warranty says reliable, reliable, reliable. Now you've got a very short time to catch on here. Because right now, this sexy Suburbanite is under 10.5. This is what Hyundai looks like today, people. Now, are you ready to get in and drive this baby? Get in the car. Now.
Nobody does it like you, the way that you do. Nobody's got the power to please me.
Hoover's exclusive two-tank system lets you pick up wet in one tank, then switch to a separate tank to pick up dry. So there's no mess emptying, wet or dry.
Nobody does it like you, Hoover. Nobody does it like you.
For President Clinton, the fruits of victory have more than a few blemishes. As he begins his second term, the president will once again face both houses of Congress led by the opposition. House Speaker Newt Gingrich and his GOP counterpart in the Senate will preside over a host of committees that are expected to step up investigations of Clinton administration activities, from Whitewater to the FBI files fiasco. Even some cases of Democratic victory last night proved a little too close for partisan comfort. In traditionally liberal Massachusetts, for example, well-known Senator John Kerry managed to keep his job, but only after a dogfight with Republican Governor William Weld, and in what was probably the ugliest race in the nation. Robert Torricelli becomes the new Democratic senator from New Jersey, but with nothing like a mandate. Several newspapers in the state refused to issue any endorsement out of disgust with campaign nastiness.
And then there are those four words that no candidate wants to hear. Too close to call. We have a case in point. The San Bernardino contest between ultra-liberal Democratic Congressman George Brown and his opponent, Superior Court Judge Linda Wild. Brown has a narrow lead with 51%, but there are still up to 10,000 absentee ballots yet to be counted. An even closer race down in Garden Grove, in fact, the closest one in the state of California. It may deprive Congress of its most outspoken firebrand. Republican Bob Dornan is known for his fiery invective, but he is not accustomed to ultra-tight races. But that is exactly what he's in, leading Democrat Loretta Sanchez by 233 votes. Randy Page has more.
Good.
In one corner, a veteran Republican congressman nationally known as a conservative firebrand, Bob Dornan, is vying for his 10th term in Congress.
And now I give to you the absolutely incredible Loretta Sanchez.
In the other, a 36-year-old Democrat who calls herself fiscally conservative and socially progressive. Loretta Sanchez has never held a public office. Both hope to serve in the 105th Congress representing Orange County's 46th District. Going into yesterday's election, polls showed it was a dead heat. Well, tonight, more than 24 hours after the polls closed, it still is. With all of the precincts reporting, Dornan leads Sanchez by a mere 233 votes, and several thousand absentee ballots still need to be counted. This is where the final tally will be made and the race will be decided. Here at the Orange County Registrar of Voters. Here, signatures on each absentee ballot are examined. Then they will be counted. And the registrar says the election will not be certified until the count is known to be accurate.
The absentee ballots are all verified, and when we're finished processing the absentee ballots, we do run those against the people that voted at the polling place, and if we find any evidence of dual voting, they are reported appropriately to the district attorney's office.
Tonight, Bob Dornan is not granting television interviews after a long election night, but he's quoted as saying he expects he will win by a slim margin, while his opponent takes a wait-and-see approach with no regrets.
We're, again, cautiously optimistic. I think a lot of those votes will be for us. There were certainly a lot of people that we took to the polls that dropped off their absentee ballot. They had already voted but needed to go to the poll to get it in on time. And so I think we hope that many of those that are outstanding will swing our way.
It will be a week before the absentee ballots are counted and another couple of weeks before the election is certified. And with less than 300 votes separating them, it could go either way. In Santa Ana, Randy Page, KCAL 9 News.
Well, some of the absentee ballots have already been counted, but many others arrive late by mail or were actually walked into the polling places, and those will not be tallied for a number of weeks. Carl Bell is up next with the forecast.
Well, looks like we're in for some warmer weather.
Vivo in Reggio Calabria, che vicinissimo a Sicilia.
And no matter what the language, nobody's hotter than Kobe Bryant.
Find out more about the Lakers star on and off the court, like how he learned to speak Italian, ahead on the 10 o'clock report.
Next on Springer.
Why poison him now? Why teach him this stuff?
They're raising their kids in the Klan.
I want to be a Klansman.
KKK Moms, next Jerry Springer.
Tonight at 11 on KCAL 9.
At Fantastic Sam's, two heads are better than one.
I want a perm, maybe. Not too tight. A body wave's all you need.
Together, we can make great things happen.
Give me something my mom would like.
We'll find the style that makes you look terrific.
Make me irresistible. Do something wild.
We'll talk over what you like and what works.
Between you and me, you're gonna look great.
So come into Fantastic Sam's.
Help.
Where two heads are better than one.
In every two-car family, there's his car and her car. His car is fun, and her car is sensible.
Can you believe that was 5 years ago?
Now, I think everybody needs a new look once in a while, even the Explorer. And now it has two airbags, four-wheel ABS, and a new suspension. The only thing Ford still hasn't solved is who gets to drive it.
I think you know I am here, Ed.
Oh, look, Jack, I'm retired. No more Burger Wars for me.
Ed, I need you to help make Jumbo Jacks.
You mean?
Yeah, at 99 cents. They're so popular, I'm having trouble keeping up with demand.
Let's do it.
I love the smell of mayo in the morning.
This is the Toys R Us space book.
It's filled with coupons you cut out.
I put the coupons on my daddy's car, so I see them real good.
Don't circle too big, or else you'll get something you really don't want.
Live and learn.
Oh, this is a very good price.
The Toys R Us big toy book with $1,700 in coupons in Toys R Us and Sunday's paper.
I give it to my brother when I'm done.
Now, KCAL 9 News continues with the 10 o'clock weather report with Carl Bell.
Warm weather as we head on into the weekend. In fact, tomorrow's only Thursday, not quite Friday into the weekend, but we can start it tomorrow. Temperatures above normal and well into the weekend. Let's first begin by taking a look at some of the beautiful conditions today out in Santa Monica. Farmers market set up there for the day. And for the weekend, I'm telling you, whatever you do, just keep it outdoors. It's going to be lovely, with temperatures well above normal for one and all, and not much wind to worry about. So if you're out there picking fruit or picking out some new clothes, you'll have mighty fine weather. Let's take a look at the current conditions right now. It's out to the Beverly Hills City Hall, and here's what we have for you right now. Clear skies and a temperature of 58 degrees, humidity 60%, wind northeast 5 miles per hour, and the barometer is rising. High for the afternoon today, 73, that's pretty much normal for this time of year. And the record 92 degrees, set back in 1898. Partly cloudy skies, scattered rain showers tonight across parts of the Pacific Northwest, from northern Oregon on into parts of Washington. This is changing over to snowfall tonight across parts of Montana and back in through parts of Idaho this evening, up to 6 inches of snow possible. For you and me, what's going to happen is high pressure is building in at the surface. That's going to give us a little bit of an offshore breeze. In the upper levels, all these clouds right here, they are arcing around an area of high pressure that's building aloft, and that means the storm track is going to push everything well north of California. No rain for the entire state through the weekend, just sunny, pleasant, warm weather from top to bottom. And just how warm? Well, first we have to get through some chilly lows for the overnight hours. 40s for some of the valleys, 40s even across the basin around Orange County near Anaheim, 49 in Lake Forest. Mountains into the 20s this evening, 53 degrees in Palm Springs, 40s for the northern valleys around the Santa Clarita, Saugus regions. Meanwhile, Oxnard at 48, and daytime highs for tomorrow, a little bit warmer, lots warmer as we head on into the weekend. Well into the 80s tomorrow for the valleys, the basin, coastal temperatures mid to upper 70s, Palm Springs tomorrow mid 80s, Big Bear at 59, Palmdale 67. And if you add 3, 4, 5 degrees onto these temperatures that you see right here, that's your weekend forecast. It looks absolutely fabulous as we head into the weekend. So three words wrap it all up for everybody, from the beaches as you move inland. Sunny and warmer. Basin into the valleys. Valleys, sunny and warmer. Daytime highs into the 80s. For the mountains and the deserts, sunny and warmer there as well. A little breezy perhaps through some mountain passes, but not too bad. Nowhere near the advisory levels that we had earlier today across some of the inland areas. And the desert, 60s to 80s. And a 5-day forecast, lots of warmth here, a lot of sunshine. It's going to be a great 5 days. Even Monday, when we cool off into the upper 70s, that's still above normal for this time of year. And even Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday of next week, mid to low 70s at the worst, or at the best, however you want to look at it. Great day. It's a beautiful day.
It's because David was born on this day.
My, oh, my. Happy birthday, David. You know, I look forward to this every year.
You do? You look forward to his birthday? Why?
I revel.
Oh, that certainly seems sincere.
Oh, because you're...
Thank you, Pat.
You know you're welcome.
See, I was born in 1965, so that makes me 31.
Oh, boy, you know, that's some
I
of that
I want to
fancy...
get out of the way of the lightning.
But you know what? That's some of that fancy new math they taught back in the mid-70s and
stuff. So that's okay. I'll buy that.
Pat'll buy that. Pat has good reason to buy that.
I'm a week behind you.
Right. That's exactly why.
Wow.
We're exactly, you know, we're a week apart.
1 week apart.
Wow.
We are 1 week apart.
Well, my number of viewers too, but we won't go into that.
David, go.
If you saw today's stock market rally, you might be thinking about investing yourself.
Happy birthday, DJ. Money man Alan Mendelson has some ideas about how to get the most out of your money on Wall Street.
And a $3 jump in Microsoft stock made America's richest man quite a bit richer. That story ahead on the 10 o'clock report. Thank you, Pat.
The funniest videos around compete for the $100,000 grand prize on America's Funniest Home Videos.
Tomorrow afternoon at 5:30 on KCAL 9.
If there's lots of places that you would like to see,
fly Southwest Airlines, because friends fly free.
Fly so you can learn.
Fly so you can earn.
For romance.
Give it a chance.
Fly so you can dance.
Fly so you can cry.
Fly so you can yell.
Fly because it's something that you were born to sell.
Fly because it's America.
From sea to shining sea.
And if you fly Southwest Airlines,
your friend flies free.
Purchase full unrestricted fare by November 20th and a friend flies free.
The 97 Accord. Still fun after all these years. Take one for a ride at your Honda dealer.
Pass it! Pass it! Pass it!
This is for my retirement!
Pass it! Pass it!
Pass it!
Pass it!
Pass it!
Pass it!
Where's the Popeye's chicken?
Popeye's chicken and Popeye's!
It's the tailgating touchdown pack. With 12 pieces of delicious Popeye's chicken and 6 fresh biscuits, this is some great football food. And it's just $10.99.
There's a network that stretches from one end of California to the other. It connects over 33,000 doctors, over 3,000 pharmacies, and 370 hospitals, and joins them for one goal: to protect the health of more than a million members. It's HealthNet, one of the biggest and most highly rated healthcare companies in the state, and California's health plan.
Today's 96-point rally in the Dow Jones Industrial Average may have you wanting to scramble for stocks, but don't rush to buy. A slower approach may give you more best buys when you invest. Money man Alan Mendelson explains.
Despite all the dips, declines, even the crashes, the stock market has been a long-term solid performer.
If you're in for the long haul, this is the place to be in. The speculators are the ones who usually lose, but if you're in for the long haul, this is the place to be.
In fact, going back about 7 decades, the stock market has gained about 11% a year. That kind of performance tells you that long-term investors, investors who buy and hold, have the best chances. One way to buy and hold is with a stock market mutual fund. Some funds let you start with as little as $100. Then add to your fund every month or every couple of months. Mutual funds give you professional management and diversification. Your one check is used to buy many stocks, so you don't put all your eggs in one basket. Mutual funds also give you liquidity. You can get out if you have to. Another savvy way to invest in the stock market is to invest in your own employee stock purchase plan at work. Wells Fargo Bank, for example, has an active employee stock purchase plan. This could be your best bet because you have inside information about your company. You know if business is good and getting better, and if its stock is worth your money. Again, it's important to invest frequently, say every week or every month. A steady investment plan means you'll average out your purchase price. If you rush in and invest a lot at one time, you run the risk of buying at a market top when prices are highest. A steady investment plan lowers your risk. And stick with it. Expect to keep your money in the stock market 3 to 5 years. But if you expect to buy a house in the next year or two, don't keep your down payment money parked on Wall Street. It might not be there when you need it. It pays to reflect on the golden rule of investing. No one ever went broke taking a profit. That's your money. Alan Mendelson, KCAL 9 News.
Some good news for Microsoft Chairman Bill Gates. If he wants to, he can eat steak every night now, finally. Prime cuts as well. Financial statements showing that Gates' stake in his powerful software company, Microsoft, now amounting to $20 billion. Of course, billion with a B. It would have been even more than that, but Gates recently sold 50,000 Microsoft shares to help cover some of his living expenses. His money is adding up.
He could eat steak every night.
Finally.
How many countries could he eat steak every night?
Different country every night. Expenses of a different kind got UCLA basketball coach Jim Herrick fired today. We will have reaction from his stunned players.
And the Lakers fall into a real hornet's nest tonight in Charlotte. Gary Cruz has highlights next on the 10 o'clock report.
Hear the tape that couldn't wait till OJ Friday. A chilling confession or boastful talk. Next, Rolanda.
Tonight at 1 on KCAL 9.
I am Autobahn, Lord of the Highways. Do you think you have what it takes to tame me? Do you? Try me. I dare you.
The all-new ES300. The road is calling. Answer it.
Come back. I let you win that time.
Are we there yet?
No. Is this it? No. This is it.
It's the Office Max Trimax Super Center.
Wow.
Three Maxes in one.
It's like nothing you've ever seen before.
An Office Max with over 7,000 products, office furniture aplenty, and Furniture Max and Copy Max, a complete printing center.
Everything under one roof.
California is where dreams come true.
Hello. Visit the new Office Max Trimax Super Centers.
All across the nation, people are asking the same question. Where's Candace?
I don't know what happened to her. All I did was show her how I count my dimes. 1 minute, 2 minutes.
It's Sprint's Dime a Minute thing, man. It's so totally popular, she's gone into hiding.
Now comes news that Sprint's made it even better.
Now you can get 10 cents a minute, 24 hours a day, to the number you call the most.
Well, that's great news, but will we ever see Candace again?
Don't hold your breath.
Call now for 10 cents a minute, 24 hours a day, to the number you call the most.
What makes this Dodge Caravan such a value is our Family Value Package. For no extra charge, you get 7-passenger seating, security drawer, air conditioning, and more. Plus, you also get seats that roll, cup holders, and storage spaces, even a great stereo. All for just $17,920. But what makes this Family Value Package so valuable is where you'll find it. In America's best-selling minivan, Dodge Caravan. See the friendly Dodge dealer near you.
Bryant dealer to the rescue and get Bryant's Plus 90i, the most totally efficient gas furnace. It can lower heating bills up to 40%. Call Bryant to the rescue. 1-800-HOT-SALES.
Call Bryant and rescue me.
This was a story. It was a blockbuster last night, David.
Really? Yeah.
Grows even more, Gary.
It continues to grow. This is one of those stories that will go on for quite some time. You know, there are
There's a lot more answers,
yeah, as we discussed at the top of the hour. You know, as I reported at the top of this hour, the Jim Herrick era is history at UCLA, and it was not pretty. After 8 seasons and an NCAA championship, Herrick was fired as head coach at UCLA for expense reports violations, which violated NCAA rules. He then lied about it. His ouster has hit home with his players.
That is our consensus, that he got a bad rap and not a fair deal, but that's the consequences you pay for a violation, I guess. We've all learned from it, that we'll now go by the book, bring receipts, everything that's needed to run a program correctly.
It's my senior year. I, 3 weeks into the season, you know, it hits you hard. And I know stuff like this in life happens, and you got to move on.
You know, losing doesn't seem so bad after that last story, but it's still not much fun. Just ask your Lakers. Nick Van Exel and Vlade Divac are still friends, and that was obvious tonight. The man the Lakers got for Vlade, 18-year-old Kobe Bryant, who had his first regular season three-point bucket. And speaking of threes, Matt Geiger stunned Shaq with a career-high 4 made buckets beyond that magical line. Geiger led his club with 22 points with a deadly outside shooting, and the Lakers lose for the first time this year, 88-78. Geiger only attempted 3 three-pointers last year alone, and he makes 4 tonight. Shaq had 21 points and 10 boards. Moving on to Miami, and is it possible for Michael Jordan to get better with age? He still has serious hops, folks. He still has serious range as he drains a 30-foot buzzer beater to end the first half. And he also still has that uncanny ability not to only fly, but find the hoop while in midair facing away from the bucket. Mike scored 50 tonight, and the Bulls beat Miami 106-100. By the way, Mike scored 50. He had no assist. Boston and Detroit also win. Chris Webber, 22 points, 21 rebounds for Washington, and it was Milwaukee beating Vancouver. Hey, let's take a peek in at the pond and check out what happened between the Mighty Ducks and Montreal tonight. Now, this was a Martin Rutinski show. He gave Montreal a 5-2 lead with his fifth goal of the year in the second period, a beauty. Down 5-3 now, Paul Kariya hits the jackpot with his first goal of the year in the third to make it a one-goal game. But just 12 seconds later, Rutinski strikes again for the third time in the game to put this one out of reach. That's right, folks. Montreal wins it 6-5 on that goal right there. And Rutinski comes up with the big hat trick. By the way, Paul Kariya also scored 2 goals tonight. In the NHL, other action, Hartford beat Boston, New Jersey blanks Detroit. Wayne Gretzky's 15-game point scoring streak ends in a tie with the Islanders. Pittsburgh and Washington also win tonight, as does Dallas and the Colorado Avalanche. Well, from the powers that be in baseball, 12 major league owners may have set their sport up for another work stoppage. The Dirty Dozen voted against a collective bargaining agreement hammered out by their hand-picked negotiator and the players' union. By the way, the negotiator, Randy Levine, he's quitting. Can you blame him? In much better baseball news, Todd Hollinsworth was named the National League's Rookie of the Year. The outfielder continues a long line of rookie greats wearing Dodger blue.
It's a very great honor in my eyes to be the fifth in a row. Something that I probably never would have dreamed of. I know in April I definitely wasn't thinking about it. Different things were going on, but to be sitting here right now in front of all of you is something that I've dreamed about and something that has come true.
Boy, what a future for him, huh? Speaking of futures, final night, Cruiser's kicker has a night off. The kicker, though, defers to a young Laker who, despite being just 18, is oh so worldly.
Vivo in Rieti, che era vicino a Roma. Vivevo in Reggio Calabria, che è vicinissimo a Sicilia. Poi vivevo in Pistoia, Reggio Emilia, che è vicino a Bologna.
Come again, please?
Well, I said I lived in Rieti, which is a city near Rome. Then I said I lived in Reggio Calabria, which is near Sicily. And I said I lived in Reggio Emilia, which is near, which is around Bologna. Then I said I lived in Pistoia as well.
Sure, Kobe speaking Italian fluently is impressive, but it's the entire Kobe Bryant package that stands out the most.
He's had a whole different experience than the average American teenager. And I think this has uniquely qualified him for his position right now. That and the fact that he's a super athlete in a 6'6", 200-pound body.
Coming to Los Angeles has opened a whole new world of opportunities for Kobe, and he's taking full advantage of them.
Is Michael Jordan doing a slam dunk?
No, but it is basketball phenom Kobe Bryant.
You stand around a lot, don't you?
I stand around a whole lot. You know me, I have a lot of energy, so I'm like bouncing up and down, you know, between takes. I'm like acting like I'm dribbling the basketball or something.
Mo, yeah. Can I talk to you for a second?
Oh, sure. What's up?
Look, Mo, it's about the SAT. I don't do well on big tests. I freeze up.
Look, if you don't do good this time, you can always take it the next time.
I'm a senior, Mo. This is next time.
You know, you have to have a lot of patience. And when the camera comes on, boom, your personality comes up. You know, when the camera's off, you're kind of tired, so you're sitting back. They say action, now you're back up again. So it's mentally draining.
Easier playing hoop, isn't it?
Oh, definitely. Definitely, a lot easier.
You know, to keep everything in perspective, he is 18. He still lives with mom and dad at home. And I was going to ask you, Dave, what'd you do with your first million at 18?
Well, you find ways to spend it, you know, when you're young.
You give it to your mother.
Now you're talking.
And I think mom has it, too. She has it. But I don't think they're going to put him on restriction.
Yeah.
No. He is just so cute.
He's delightful.
Guy. He's a great guy.
Boy, he's going to be a phenomenal basketball player.
Very smooth Italian.
Every time I mention his name to Jerry West goes, yeah.
He smiles. Yeah, that's good.
He's with himself.
He's special.
All right.
Thanks for joining us at 10 o'clock tonight.
We'll see you back here tomorrow. Yeah.